Hello. Have fun trying to get me. Ha 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 ha. You silly man. Stop behaving like Morrowind.
What?
That's all you got.
Ha! It's actually right here. It's not even out far. Good. What did he throw away? A strong box. Ooh, his diary. Oh. Okay. Let's hide here and read it. First letter. My name is Yero Sunwind, and this is my first life letter. Last night, Sierra and I had a lengthy talk about our plans for the future. At one point, Sierra noticed that a lot of visionaries tend to become cynical. The reason being, they lose sight of their goals. These documentations shall record my aspirations. In moments of weakness, I want to read these, to remind myself of what is dear to me. Well, this is the first one. Just yesterday, the Keeper of the Order from Ark visited the village, and if that weren't enough, he also detected some magic inside of me. Is that even possible? Me, an Arcanist. It's difficult to express my feelings with words. I feel like all my hard work is finally paying off. Interestingly, this arouses a peculiar, somewhat morbid thought. Maybe it is, in some sad way, even good that my mother passed away. Why? Because it opened my eyes. Now I don't feel anything other than a lack of understanding. And yes, even anger towards the simpletons of the village, both the children and adults. Day after day, it is always the same. They get up, work, and let themselves be amused by the bards in the evening. Can't they see what's happening with the world? Everything they pass on. Should it really be just a brief inscription on a stone? Sierra is different. She understands me. She shares my dream. And if Master Igraz accepts her as an apprentice, we could continue to be as close in the novitiate as we are right now. Second letter. 15 years have passed, and a lot of my wishes have come true. Sierra and I are now living together, but with the craftsmen instead of in the temple quarters. It has been 5 years since I completed the holy trial. Despite what I had originally planned, I have decided against the military path and will be a school teacher instead. Why? Because I believe that I can teach a lot more people by sharing my vision with the young, rather than fighting in wars. Such things might sometimes be necessary, but they stand for everything that I stand against. Beyond that, the Truchessa has recently adopted the food bank bill, which Sierra and I developed together. Once a year, rich Andralians are obliged to contribute a handful of pennies into a chest with which the poorest in the Undercity are brought a warm meal. The reactions were mixed. Some agreed most enthusiastically, while others were outraged. Often I would hear things like, it's their own fault they live in misfortune, or if they would actually work, they wouldn't starve. Such people make me furious. What cursed ignorance is this? Of course it's easy for them to see the sky from the top of their ivory towers, but they will never understand the plight of the poor. Despite how angry this letter might seem, I'm quite content overall. I'm starting to feel as if I have a purpose, that I'm moving in the right direction. And my happiness is due in no small part to the woman who has always stayed by my side throughout all these years. It's strange. I know you'll probably never read these pages, just as I might never see one of your letters, but still, I have the feeling as I'm writing these words that I'm talking to you through the ink. With that in mind, I love you, Sierra. Third letter. Sierra is dead. Killed by a group of scoundrels as she was delivering food to the food bank in the Undercity. How quickly these words have been written down, but how can I express this anguish, this emptiness, even remotely? Sounds so absurd. I'm talking to a piece of paper because no one else wants to listen to me, nor could they even remotely understand what this means to me. Sierra always told me that these letters would give me strength, but they don't. These lines appear unfamiliar to me. Everything feels wrong. I feel wrong as I get up in the morning. I feel wrong when the sun hides behind the cloudy sky at noon, and I feel wrong as I lie alone in this big bed in the evening. Malphus judges suicide to be a sin, since every one of us has a purpose in life to fulfill. But could this really be my purpose? I might have 30 winters left at most, depending on whether or not an illness snatches me away. And behind me I can see nothing but failed dreams. our damned food bank has led to downright war in the banquets of the Undercity. The rich trying to weasel their way out of making payments as much as they can, and in front of me I can see nothing but fog? It seems most fitting. So tell me, Melfus, is this really my path? Is this my purpose, to be a failure whose fate is to die alone? My thoughts are chaotic and I'm tired. I don't want to keep writing. Wow. So wait a second, what day was the last one on? Oh, it doesn't say. No, it doesn't say the date, but assuming that was recent? So he was really depressed. Therefore, he did have a reason to explode himself in a horrible way, I guess. But he was, you know, his eyes glowed red and everything. Penta's house discovered. Who is Penta? Assuming we shall soon find out who Penta is. Firm leather armor, handicraft 20. Where's the key to get into Penta's house? Ah. Well then. So we're not going in there. More wolves. Which is good. Does mean we could get some pelts. That was oddly cute. Switch! Switch! But yeah, I hit my buff like while I was shooting the bow, so it actually cued it and happened afterwards, which kind of screwed me over. You guys are failing horribly to attack me, by the way. Not gonna complain. I'm just gonna keep strafing. Give me some leather, please. Damn it! I want to make some cool armor. But yeah, I think maybe I will do some leather crafting. Put some skills into that. That sounds exciting. But I will also gather materials for other things. Best way to get ashore here. Is there a local maps? Yeah, there is, but it's not super helpful. Yeah, we just gotta go inland a bit. Maybe I'll find a path if I wander around here. God, this castle up there is so cool looking. Wouldn't be mad at a few more wolves. If you wanna throw that at me here. Wood crabs work too. Crabs. King crabs. Whatever they are. Imposing king crab. What are you imposing, Mr. Crab? Look, clearly nothing successful. Ooh, pretty close. Let's kill these crabs. Try and level up. Hello. Wow. Yay. Stamina. If I'm going this kind of build, I need stamina. Hey, who are you hiding from? You can hide from me? Well, you're wrong, Mr. Crab. Hunting crabs on the beach. Great pastime. Ooh, there's another one over there. Got my arrows. Saw another one. Whatever. Excuse me. You have to die also, I'm afraid. Sorry. You know. No offense. You just have to die. There's an altar thing up there. Okay, so let's meditate. Right, let's do this. Shadow of the Wind. Damage with bow. And then that leads to, if you attack while you're sneaking, your critical hit chance is increased by 10. So is this doesn't say when I'm not detected, it says when I'm sneaking. So that could be really powerful if that's how that works. If I can be detected in sneaking. What are these? Sneak attacks with bows. Yeah. I can't help it. How many do I have left? I have one left. Assassin. Sneak attacks with one-handed weapons. I think sneak attacks with bows. Yeah. That's what I'm using the most. So, what is this now? Throw a flash powder which blinds your enemy for a period of time to give you time to hide. Oh, blinded enemies cannot be attacked. That's cool. That's like, yeah, that is totally like Thief. Someone said that in the comments. I think that's what they meant. That's so great. It's like a flash bomb. Okay. So now that that's good, let me check this stuff out here. Book light armor. Increase your light armor for apprentice. Yeah, I'll spend one on light armor, I think. I'm not gonna focus on magic, I don't think. For my ranged, I will try and just worry about the bow. Maybe. Okay, let me switch back to the Shadow of the Wind. That's good. We are now leveled up more. I didn't get any actual abilities, did I? No. I did not. Wait. Spell Ward. Increase armor rating and reduces suffered damage. So good, why wasn't I using that? Oh, it's that spell, okay. That's actually not that good. Thought it was a buff, but no. Anyway. Myriad Tower at the Suncoast. Let's go and talk to this fellow. He looks like he's probably gonna be friendly. Hello there. Yay.
Watch yourself. The streets aren't safe this time of the day.
But it's the morning, what do you mean?
Watch yourself.
Okay.
The streets aren't safe this time of the day.
Why? Hi.
A foreigner, huh?
Yeah.
What a surprise.
Sorry. Sorry to surprise you. Or not surprise you.
That's just how it is.
Hello, Streetzel. No, oh, no. Good dog. Riverville, Merrick's Farm. I can go in. Hello. Vexen. Can I talk to you? No? How about you?
Ahoy.
Hi.
Ahoy.
Well, okay then. See you later. Alright. Let's battle through this frame rate here and... Hello.
Hey, ooh. You there!
Hi.
Yes, you! Do you want to know a secret?
Yes. What do you mean?
Well, I found something. Something really, really awesome. But I need help from somebody as tall and strong as you. How about it? I show you what I mean, and you promise to help me in return. What do you say?
Could you be a little more specific? What did you find?
I'll show you in a moment, but first, you have to promise to help me. Come on, don't be a chicken!
Why exactly are you asking me and not your parents? I'm a complete stranger and could be dangerous.
Dangerous? I don't know. You wouldn't be as close to the village and to the guards then, would you? And I don't want Daddy and the others to find out about this. That would spoil the surprise.
Alright, I'll help you. Show me the secret.
Awesome! I knew you'd say yes! Come, follow me!
This is gonna be horrible, isn't it? I know it's gonna be horrible. I have a bad feeling. Are you a creepy child?
That's just how it is.
Where are you going?
Everything was better in the old days.
What are you doing? Okay. Oh!
Look, I found this yesterday when I was searching for shelves. Awesome, isn't it?
Was that there a second ago? Because I was just here killing crabs. Well, it's a casket.
Yes, and you know what? If you shake it, you can hear a rattling, as if there are coins in it. All we need to do is break it open, then we can split the loot, and I could give Daddy the money for the pointy beard man. So what do you think? I've already tried to open it, but it just won't budge.
Pointy beard man?
Yeah, that man from the big city, who always comes after a moon turn. He wants money from the farmers. Daddy says he works for this Jank or Boric or something like that.
You mean landlord. So I take it your daddy owes this landlord money?
Yeah, I think so. He always tries to make us think everything is okay, but I'm not stupid. And maybe there are enough pennies in this box for Daddy to pay the pointy beard man. Who knows?
Alright, I'll try it.
Sure.
Can't be too difficult, right? Okay.
Awesome!
Yeah.
Let's see what's in there!
Loot it!
There are... Oh, come on, what is that?
What is it?
There aren't any pennies, only these weird nails and a piece of paper. Here, take a look for yourself.
I didn't see any nails. Old note. Day and night it stands there, sublime, proud, and full of power, giving blessings in time of need on our path until we die.
So, does it say anything?
It looks like some kind of poem to me. I'm not sure.
A poem? What if it's a riddle? That's what you grown-ups call it, don't you? What does it say exactly?
Read out the first verse.
A blessing in distress? That... Oh, sugar. Why do you grown-ups always have to talk so complicated? That is... Wait. Father Vildas, the priest, he always talks about blessings at the sermons. Maybe the writer is talking about the shrine.
Uh-huh.
The one behind our house. Quickly, you should go take a look over there. I have to go back to the farm to feed the lures, but tell me at once if you find anything.
Yeah, I was gonna guess the shrine. I was honest. Blazing spark. Is this the shrine in question? Maybe it's not. Maybe there's another shrine? I don't know where his house is. You seem to have a little bit of a problem there, sir. Are you feeling okay? There seems to be a hoe sticking through your back. I'm gonna follow this kid and see where his home is. If he can figure out how to get there. Does he have a last name? No. Okay, then.
I hope the new turnips come soon.
Hello.
All you'll ever need. But please, take a look.
Anything interesting around here?
Apart from my wares, you mean? Well, jokes aside, no. At the moment, it's quiet around here. Thank Malphus it is. And you don't hear a lot of good things from the streets these days. Vatiers, brigands. This country has seen better times.
Wait. What do you
have in stock? Oh, a lot! Tell me if something catches your eye.
I will do. Tomato soup. Really, that's it? That's all you have? But you do have 50 gold. I guess I could sell you a couple things. Here, you know. Have fun with that stuff. I didn't look at how much damage this does. It's so good. I gotta use that. Spell tome, blazing spark. Huh. Bolt of lightning that does 15 shock damage and half as much mana. Okay, he's out of money. That's fine. Thank you.
Walk blessed.
Hello, Priest Vildis.
Walk blessed, my child. How may I help you?
I'm an outlander. Could you explain to me what this path really is?
What it is? Now that's quite the question you're asking there. But fine, why not? The path is two things. For one, it is the name of holy writing that encompasses both the revelation of the Lightborn after the fall of the Eterna King Azatarun and the journey of the first vassals to Enderal, who founded this country under Malphus's guidance. It also tells us the virtue of the path, the ideals by which every Endrelian should live, which is the only way to salvation.
Okay, thank you.
You are welcome, child. Walk blessed.
Yeah. I'm hurt. Can you heal me?
Let me see. Yes, that is no injury light magic couldn't heal. Malphus blessed this body, rid it of its afflictions and endow it with life, path abidingness, and new strength. May your light guide this soul.
Yay, thank you. I guess I should ask you about this too. Has anything interesting happened recently?
Well, I suppose that depends on what you deem as interesting. I am certain you have heard about the tragic events in Ark. Apparently the Magister who murdered those children was from Riverville himself. And then there's the Mayor's wife. She's been sick for moons now, and even I cannot help her. Dreadful times are these, truly. I wish I could do more.
Okay. I gotta find that guy here somewhere. There's a guy named Alfred or something. Just keep looking, I suppose. Hello, Mr. Guard? Quarrenoi Gatsigor Malatalala?
Yes?
Any news?
News? Where have you been these past moons? The whole city's talking about nothing else but the Mad Magister. 30 dead novices. Oh, boy. How could something like this happen? Within the Order?
I don't know, but I'm investigating it. I'm new to the city and looking for work. Do you know where I can find any?
Work, huh? If you know a thing or two about herbs and the healing arts, you should talk to the mayor. His companion has been sick for moons now. Poor Mathilda. I've never met a woman more generous than her. She doesn't deserve that.
Okay. I can do that. Hello, Jail.
Walk blessed.
Any news?
Aye. Many, and hardly any good ones. The streets are swarming with highwaymen and brigands these days. More than I've seen in all the years I've served now. What's happening to this world, I wonder? Seems everyone is eager to go at each other's throats. It's a shame.
It is a shame.
Yes?
Nothing. Alright, so here's some more houses. Hello, cow. I'm curious about this dancing woman. Hello, Turhuti Lalalurk?
Oh.
Are you okay?
Oh. I sense vibrations. Horrible, bad vibrations. Oh, yes, I feel them very strongly.
Bad vibrations?
Oh, yes. Something peculiar surrounds you. Your aura! Oh, by Malthus, no!
What? What about it?
It is indigo blue, the color of the dying.
Oh.
It must be a magical anomaly, but still, that doesn't bode well.
Could you stop dancing while I'm talking to you?
You're lucky. The stars are on your side. I, just like you, find myself in deep trouble. And maybe we can help each other.
Okay, how can you help me?
I have a special object in stock. A skull. According to the legends, it comes from the midst of the Kiran Desert, and us Arcanists refer to it as the Master Skull. It is a risky experiment, but at midnight, if you balance the skull on your head for one full hour, it might help to reharmonize your aura. Maybe.
That sounds like a load of crap. Look, if you want me to help you, I want something useful in return, not some skull.
Oh, such distrust in the cosmic powers. Well, a horse can only be led to the water. Drinking has to be done by the horse itself. If it's coin you're after, you shall have it. A couple of days ago, something precious was stolen from me. My beauty potion. And until yesterday, I was in the dark as to who took it. A vision has shed light onto the matter.
Where are you going?
It was an aura thief.
Okay, I'll see if I can find your potions. Where should I start looking?
I have a suspicion. Yesterday, when I danced at the river, I heard a voice out of nowhere whispering right into my ear. And it only said 6 words. Find me in the Clearwater Cave. I'm sure it was the potion who spoke to me, but I'm too old to go exploring old caves like this one on my own, which is sad since said cave is only a few minutes' march from the village. It's an abandoned mine just up the hill that leads to the pass.
Yep, I've seen it.
Go there and find my potion, and I will reward you most generously.
I like how she kept getting farther and farther away with me as I talked to her. It's weird. Alright, potion of beauty. Whatever. If I go to that cave, I'll get it. Manison's house, eh? Coal. Not sure if I need that. Hello, children. Manison, hi.
Who are you?
Good question. Never mind, I don't feel like telling you. So, I don't see...
Do you know the aged man of who no one knows from where...
Hello?
Hey, you there! You want to know a secret?
Oh god, another secret? What kind of secret?
A really great secret, you'll see. If you, give me 30 pennies and I'll tell you.
Why should I believe your secret is really worth 30 pennies?
Because I promise. Please. With those pennies, I can have Mizir Gatsudoma make me a wooden horse like the one Sen has. Please.
I don't care about your wooden horse. Shove off.
Ugh, you're really mean. You know that? All right, then. You're lost.
I don't have to give some random child 30 pennies. Jeez.
Greetings.
It's not even my child. Greetings. Piggies.
Some shifts never end.
Okay, let's go in here then. Hello, excuse me for barging in.
Yes?
Excuse me, I'm new to the area. Do you happen to have any tips?
Well, I might. But I'm sure as heck not going to tell you, Moonskin. Now leave me alone. I don't have time for chit-chat.
Wow. Okay, fine. Okay, oh, there's that kid. Where's your house, kid? Trying to find a shrine behind a house. Clearly I haven't explored all of Riverview, right? Some camp over here. I'm just leaving the town right now. Yeah. Okay. We're definitely going the wrong direction. Never mind about all these side quests. Let's just do our main objective. Here we go. Here we go. Aha! Hello, Wash. Wash. This is nice. Nice view. Aldrus Root.
Well, there comes a point when you just have to live with it.
Okay.
Madame?
Hello? Doggy? Excuse me. Are you Alfred?
Who are you?
Just a traveler. You're Alfred, right? The childhood friend of a man named Yero?
Yero.
Yero.
This is about his death, isn't it?
Yes.
The rampage.
Yes. You've heard about it?
Of course. Who hasn't? Yero was one of us, after all. It is terrible. Simply terrible. You want to hear an old man's opinion, though? I always expected that something like this would happen.
Really?
Malthus, forgive me for talking about a keeper like that, but it's the truth.
You mean you saw it coming? How?
Hard to explain, really. Come on, let's find somewhere to sit. It'll be easier to talk that way.
Okay.
Well, Yero. That's quite a subject, you know. You were right when you said we were best friends. Our fathers knew each other. For as long as I can remember, Yero and I were getting into trouble together. At least, until his mother died.
Not of old age, I assume?
No. Bandits killed her in broad daylight on Penny Road. Today these incidents are common, but not back then. The road was considered safe. Very safe. She was on her way to Ark, accompanied by three other women, and they were set upon at the pass. None of them survived. Yero was shattered. I think the worst part was how his father went downhill after his wife's death. The fishery decayed, and the poor guy filled his days with boozing and sleeping. It changed Yero forever.
How exactly?
Well, that's a good question. On the one hand, he became a man, despite his tender age. On the other hand, something inside him woke up, so to speak. A desire to make more of his life. Old Mother Jenica noticed it and took him under her wing. He learned how to read and write, and soon he knew all the holy verses by heart. When he didn't have to help his drunken father, he helped in the village as much as he could.
He transformed his grief into productivity. Sounds like a rather positive development.
Indeed. That's one way to look at it. It wasn't long before he was the jewel of the village. The striving young fisherman destined for great things, even though he was only on the path of a manufacturer. And then, the inevitable happened. A keeper of the order came to Riverville to see the prodigy with his own eyes. And behold, in addition to Yarrow's ingenuity, he also had a slumbering magical talent. The keeper took him away, and a few months later, he started his novitiate. Since then, I've only seen him once or twice, as he rarely visited Riverville. I don't think he ever noticed how much that hurt me.
Aww. Is that common for someone in the manufacturer's path to get a chance to become a keeper?
If one of the manufacturers makes it to Sergeant of the Guard, it's reason enough for a bard song. He must have been the first novice in centuries who was not of the sublime path. So yes, sir, it is uncommon. More than that.
So what did you mean by, I always suspected that something like this would happen?
Oh, it's hard to explain. I believe it was the way he was talking about his grand plans. How he wanted to make the world a better place. To become the greatest keeper since Lorem Waterblade. Underneath all this, there was an anger. An anger mixed with deep grief and disappointment. I don't think he was aware of it because he drew all his strength from that anger. The strength to do all this, to learn and to work day and night, but it frightened me, like the Blue Death. It slumbers inside the pathless mage who believes he can master magic without the Order's help.
Ah.
At first, it grants power, but then, one day, it bursts out in an unholy wave of destruction, turning him into one of the monsters in the old songs. Anyway, I'm just an old man. What do I know about these matters? Now let me go to sleep, my dame. All these memories are making me weary.
All right, thank you for your help.
Yes, of course.
Right, well, I guess we did it. So, now we continue exploring Riverwood, and then, what are you doing, dog? Stop running back and forth. I don't want to call him a bad dog, because I like doggies. So yeah. I think we will talk to the mayor, possibly, who is up here, no doubt. Do some bartering. Ooh, yeah, definitely gonna explore this area. And, then, we will head back to Jesper. Wow, that's cool looking. I guess if we're going back, we should make sure Romarin is with us, huh? We shouldn't leave him here. That would just be rude. Okay. Hello, Romarin. Welcome back. Romarin, please stop being weird and follow me. Follow me.
I'm right behind you.
I... Romarin? Did I say something wrong? I'm sorry. Romarin, please don't leave. Oh boy. Romarin has reluctantly... He left our group, basically, and wandered back towards Nella's house. We left Solstheim to continue on our business, because we don't have time to waste. If he wants to be, you know, a pouty pants, then that's fine. We'll just catch up with him later. In the meantime, Anamla and I will do some worthwhile adventuring and make some more money and become more powerful than we could ever imagine. Right, Anamla? Okay. Anyone?
doesn't feel like coming to life around here. Tulfdir, you might want to look at this. What in the world is this?
Well now, why is this buried so far within...
Please don't chase me back to town. I think they will frown upon that if I bring a dragon to Winterhold. I will not be very popular. I wouldn't go that way if I was you. What?
We're here to teach you a
lesson. What? What? Oh my god,